What's up, Skip?
I have a feeling you're going to have something to say about some of those picks. All right, what did you like and what did you not like from those picks?
Joe Klatt, I loved and hated your first round of
that's the beauty of it.
I'm going to mock some of your mock draft
picks. Please, that's what it's for.
When it comes to quarterbacks. Okay. Obviously, I think we all agree by now, I was ahead of this curve. Kyler Murray is going to be easily the best player in this entire draft, and he should go first to the Arizona Cardinals. But after Kyler Murray, I am on record. There's only one other quarterback I like in this entire draft, and he is not Daniel Jones, who you have going 15th to the Washington Redskins. I think that would be a really bad idea. He's not even Dwayne Haskins, who you have going 6th to the New York Football Giants. He is Will Grier, the 32nd pick in your mock draft. I think Will Grier, over time, has the moxie and the guts and the sort of style and flair to replace Tom Brady without crumbling under the pressure to do that. I like his game. I like his star power. He has a nice arm and a nice manner about him. And all of his siblings, I don't know how, became internet stars.
Oh,
So he's got some star quality.
They're the stars.
I don't think he would be overwhelmed by having ultimately to replace Tom Brady, but it would be 3 years. So I think he would be on that Aaron Rodgers track in Foxborough that Aaron was behind, obviously, Brett Favre. Shannon Sharpe, it took 3 years for Aaron Rodgers to rebuild his delivery and get ready to replace. And when it was time to replace Brett Favre, he stepped right into the fray and did not miss a beat.
Okay.
Now, back to Dwayne Haskins. I'm just not sold.
Okay.
And I've said it several times. Second round pick, maybe. There's something I don't love about his ability to handle pressure in the pocket because he didn't have much pressure. They really protected him. And so many of his throws were underneath throws to his track team of receivers who had run after catch like crazy. And we got to see the track team on full display at the combine. You were there, and you saw Paris Campbell go 4.31 in the 40, and Terry McLaurin, he ran 4.35, and Johnny Dixon ran 4.41, and it's like,
It was like that.
And that's who he was dinking and dunking to with Big Yak. Mm-hmm. So, again, Is he going to be the face of the football Giants? Can he replace Eli Manning starting game one next year? I don't think so. I think that would be a bad idea. I think Daniel Jones would be a bad idea. I think Will Grier would be a great idea.
So you you like Will Grier at 6, not 32?
No, to the Patriots, that would work.
Okay. You like
if you could get him at 32, again, you might be able to get Will Grier if you waited a little bit into the second round.
It's interesting that you say that because I think that if you read a lot of the pundits, you would expect that Will Grier was going to be available maybe in the second round or later. But if you talk to the people within the National Football League, you will know that they are much higher on Will Grier than those that are writing about the draft. Hmm. Will Grier is a guy that has impressed in the meetings with these teams, and he played really big in his biggest moments of the season last year, mainly in his two toughest opponents against Texas, which we were there for that game in Austin, and against Oklahoma to finish up the year.
Friday night, I watched it. He put on a show.
It was a show.
Against a bad defense, but he put on a show.
Granted, it was a terrible defense, but he threw for 900 yards, 7 touchdowns, no interceptions and combined in those two games. He's mature. He's very mature after what he had to deal with early in his college career and then going. He's got a child now. He is a very mature guy.
By the way, he had a PED suspension at Florida and ended up transferring to West Virginia.
He grew up a lot from that. Now, some of the knocks on Will Grier are more related to the system and specifically how Dana Holgorsen, his head coach, kind of coached the system. Hmm. He held the ball, Shannon, a lot in the pocket, waiting for the big shot down the field. Because of that, he took some unnecessary sacks and risks late in what I would call or deem the shot clock.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I like Will a lot. NFL people like Will a lot. And because of that development, maybe for a couple of years behind Tom is why I thought he was a great fit there at number 32.
I like it.
Let me go now to Dwayne Haskins. I'm going to defend Dwayne because Dwayne could only operate and execute the plays that were being called. All right?
Okay.
And they were – Ohio State last year was in a internal war, not a malicious war, but an internal tug of war about style of offense.
Right.
Because what Urban had done for his entire career and what he was comfortable with is not what Dwayne was really good at and what his skill set lent itself to. And so they were constantly trying to find the happy medium. And what you ended up seeing is a guy late in the year blossom. Okay, once that tug of war ultimately played out, this guy was playing the best football in the country, even with Kyler Murray out there in his last three games. We saw that on full display against Michigan. Albeit a dink and dunk, yes, but what do you do against a man-to-man coverage when you've got all those track stars? You run them across
right,
the field.
Right.
That's a game
just
plan.
Just get them the ball.
That's right. And he did that, and he did that beautifully. In order to get yards after the catch, you've got to have great timing and great ball placement. And that's what equals yards after the catch. He was able to do that. He doesn't deal with pressure great or very well within the pocket. His footwork needs some development. That's why I like him to the Giants, because I don't think he's got to start week one for the New York Giants. I think he can develop over time. And his character, his stature, and his style, I think, fit New York, what Gettleman wants, their GM, and that's why I put him there. And I will say this again, I'm going to circle back on this. New York took the best football player in the draft last year, and Saquon Barkley, and it was the wrong pick for them. What good does Saquon Barkley do for you if you don't have the future at quarterback? You have got to address that position. If they don't at the number six pick or in a trade, maybe with Arizona, we'll see, then who cares if you have Saquon Barkley?
Are you sure about Sam Darnold?
I'm pretty sure about Sam Darnold.
I'm not completely convinced.
I'm okay,
because
almost
you're saying they should
convinced.
Have taken Sam Darnold.
No question about right? it. Mm. Yeah, no question.
I think the guy that's tailor-made for the Patriots is Irv Smith Jr. Mm. They lose Gronkowski. He can block, and Coach Belichick knows guys that come out of Alabama.
Yeah.
He know they're going to be disciplined.
He had the Bama shirt on.
Yeah,
that pro
he, know, he knows they're going to be hard worker. Skip, the Patriots have six of the top 101 picks. So they have a first rounder, two twos, and three threes. Mm-hmm. They have the ammunition to move up or down or to accumulate more picks if they see someone they like.
That is
true. But what I've noticed about them when it comes to selecting a quarterback, they believe is more system-tuned. So they don't need a guy that's great that needs to make plays off script. Tom Brady's not running around, rolling to his left, and throwing the ball here and there. He plays on script. And so they saying it's our system. Mm-hmm. I don't see them looking at a quarterback and says, wow, he's just a must-have. Because they feel they can go get a quarterback in the second round or the third round and be just as good as these guys because of the way they coach them in New England. So I think Irv Smith would be perfect for them. But I agree with you on the Giants. They got to get a quarterback somehow, whether you trade or whether you borrow one for a year. But you need a quarterback. Now, it looks like they might be interested in Josh Rosen, but the thing is that draft picks doesn't seem to have the same cachet they once did, unless you're Khalil Mack and you're going to give up two first-rounders. Skip, because if you wait to the draft, if you got a car and you buy the exact type of car, I know you got to get rid of this old one. I'm not going to give you what you wanted for before you got the new one.
That's right.
So the longer you hold on to him, Arizona, you're not fooling anybody. Mm. Talking about, oh, we like Josh Rosen, and we think he can be a great player. Yada, 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 yada. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we know, but we're not buying that. Go ahead and trade him, because that's what you're going to do. But I believe you'll get the most bang for your buck now, as opposed to waiting close to the trade deadline.
You know what?
I think there are three teams that I have heard and I know are very interested in Josh Rosen, and that's New England, that's the New York Giants, and that's the LA Chargers. And one of those have already offered a second round pick.
It better not be New England. Josh Rosen would be a disaster in New England.
Yeah,
I'm just telling. Listen, I'm just. This is Big J, as Colin says it. Those are the three teams that have expressed some interest. Mm-hmm. There is one of those that has offered firmly a second round pick for Josh Rosen. Arizona is waiting for a first. I don't think they'll get it.
They're not getting it.
But right now, there's a second round pick on the table, so he's going to get moved. Just what's the price? I think they're kind of waiting for the timing and ultimately what is that second round pick, but I don't think that they're going to get a first for him.
Josh Rosen, low football intangibles. That's just me.
Yeah.
You've never been really high.
Backbone.
Well, you better trade it while the price is like gold. You keep waiting. It will go to $1,000 an ounce. It could come down to $400 an ounce.
Okay. And everybody knows they're not just going to keep him in the garage.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, the car analogy.
So you know what my conclusion is to
what?
All this? If the New York Giants, with the sixth overall pick, took Will Grier, I would have no issue with it. Seriously. Sometimes you have to think way outside the box. He's the second-best quarterback. I think he's a little better than Dwayne Haskins, maybe a lot better. And I think he would fit in New York.
Well, both of them might be a little better than Eli is right now.
Well, but hey, I'll give you that. I will give you that. But you could throw Will Grier into the starting lineup in New York in game one, and he would be just fine.
I don't know, Skip.
The stage would not be too big for him.
Morgantown, West Virginia is a long way from the Big Apple, New York.
No, but he started out in Gainesville, Florida with a lot of heat. Man, he was a highly sought, highly recruited. Yeah, he was a five-star.
I know Nash probably hopes he's in New York. That's one of his brothers. He's got like millions of
dollars. Millions. It's incredible.
Yeah.
It's the future, what all the cool kids are doing, Shannon.
So, even you would be jealous of his Instagram followers.
Will Grier?
Nash. Anyways.
Wait a second. So you want Tom Brady to get the third best tight end in the draft? Is that what you want? Because the two Iowa kids are going to go
I don't think they're going to get to New England. I don't think T.J. Hockenson you're referring to and Noah Fant, both from Iowa. Fant's a little bit more athletic, more splashy.
Yep.
Hockenson is kind of a do-everything guy.
Irv Smith.
We'll
I like
see.
Irv.
I don't think those two, I don't think they'll make it all the way
down. Well, I know they will. I'm just saying. So you want the third best tight end in New England?
They're not moving up to select a tight end.
How did Iowa have two of the best, the two best tight ends in the country on the
same
team?
Those kids.